Hello ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot with the start of a very special playthrough. We're going to be playing Walking with Dinosaurs for the PS3 using the PS Wonderbook and the PS Move controller. This is obscure, a little strange, but it's got characters from the Walking Dinosaurs 3D movie. It's okay, it's for children, but it looks very, very cool. And I'm really excited. I've got my little PS Move lollipop thing in my hand, and we are ready to give this a go. I've never played this before, as you can see. What about, I don't want profile 1, I want profile 2. What if I want profile 2? How do I change? Do I use the controller? No? Okay, whatever. That'll do. Ooh! See, you can see the cushion is to shield my mic from the, okay. That'll do. This doesn't really work. It kind of just goes to accept without me doing anything. Oh, whatever. That's minor details. Minor details. Your wonder book is out of... Oh, no.
For an incredible journey that will take you back millions of years to a time of wonder when the most magnificent creatures ruled our planet. An entire prehistoric world exists inside this...
I can move it!
Your guide to how these giant reptiles lived, fought, and died. Come with me. Come walking with dinosaurs.
Oh my god. I'm actually moving this. Do I open the book? I'm gonna open the book. No, it's not. Look, it's there.
I'll teach you how to use the Wonder Book and play all the games. If you can find all the facts and win lots of gold medals, then you'll become a certified dino expert. Listen carefully to the facts you discover, as I'll be testing your knowledge at the end of each chapter. Oh, and if there's more than one of you playing, why not take turns with the controller to share the fun? Okay?
Share the fun. Start. What's she on about?
Controller at the book and press the move button.
This is awesome! Move controller, it's turned into like a weird little scepter of magic.
Digging up the past. The Canadian Badlands are a famous fossil hotspot, with discoveries dating back literally millions of years.
Awesome! Let's dig up a dinosaur!
Meh.
Of hundreds of lost species.
Oh my god.
Beneath our feet, waiting to be found.
Use the hammer to smash up that rock.
Press okay.
The move button to switch to the hammer. Just keep hammering.
Oh my god.
Keep hammering until you hit dirt.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to clarify this is the coolest thing I've ever done in my life. Can I turn that? Yeah, there we go. That's better. Because I'm having to hold the book up for you guys, I mean, I can put it... No, that's probably better. Ah! This is really... I just want to show you guys this for a second, just to clarify how cool this is. Like, you can see the book there. Like, to the right of the screen, and then you put it back in and... It's awesome! It really is! Let's beat it up a little bit more, though. Okay. I'm a little worried I'm just going to smash it to pieces. Apologies if this is a bit loud, but... Come on, you.
Now use your brush to sweep the dirt away. Sweep the brush over the page to clear away the dirt. Excellent. That's it.
I'm a paleontologist.
Keep dusting. I can see bones.
Ooh, fancy. Okay, where's that? There we go.
Your first dinosaur. I wonder what it is. Now pick up the fossils and slot them into the skeleton.
Okay.
Hold the T button to pick up a bone. Now where does it fit? That looks sharp.
No.
Looks like it's part of the tail.
Eh.
Done.
Thanks.
Is that a rib?
And the other finger's a tooth.
That didn't fit.
I mean, it does fit, short game. Oh, it's a... I didn't see that down there.
It's starting to take shape. That's on the foot. Look at that tooth!
This is Gorgon, a Gorgosaurus, and the deadliest predator of his age.
This is the coolest game I've ever played in my life.
You've unlocked your first fact card. See how many you can collect throughout the chapter. If you find them all, you'll be well on your way to becoming a certified dinosaur expert.
I want to stroke it. Meow. I am in a slightly opposite position, and the cushion doesn't really help, so...
You need to put every bone in the right position first time. As you play through the book, you'll win gold, silver, or bronze medals for each of the games. You can replay games to get the best medals. Just click on the picture to play the game again. Look, you've unlocked a new game.
You need to calm down, Gorgon. You need to calm down.
A deadly predator who targets the weak and the sick. In combat, he's unstoppable. A highly evolved killing machine with an insatiable appetite for flesh.
Uh-oh, he's coming our way.
Screw you, Gorgon.
He'll see you.
Is he gonna go away?
Phew. I thought we were done for. I hope that's the last we'll see of Gorgon.
Silly Gorgon. Who does he think he is? Kids these days.
Great job!
Thanks.
Didn't get eaten. That was amazing! I wonder what's up next. Turn to the next page.
But I didn't get a gold medal. Oh, whatever.
$75 million ago. The last great age of the dinosaurs.
You need to find all the hidden creatures shown in the picture. Use your controller to select the picture, and then press the move button to look inside.
Okay, let's start from the left, I think. Oh, there's one down here. Cheeky. Yeah. What? Oh.
It's like looking into the past. Use your controller to move the eye around the world. If you see a magnifying glass appear, then press the move button to take a closer look. Can you find the bird? Move the eye over it once you've found it.
Is that not the bird? This is this kind of bird-shaped thing here. Oh, the eye there.
Now, press the move button. Oh, he's moved. Move the eye over him again. He's flown over to the left now. Move the eye to find him again. And now
will you just bloody stay still?
He's up there.
Come on. Where have you gone? There you are, you sneaky little goose.
This prehistoric bird is called Alexornis.
Well done. Let's see if you can find all the hidden creatures.
Thanks. Wow. Hello, puppet.
Here come some dinosaurs. And they're huge.
They're just big bones. Be nice.
These are Pachyrhinosaurus. At 12 years old, Oak is in the prime of his life and leads a large herd. Apache is a young male. You can spot him by the hole in his armored frill. Juniper is Patchy's closest companion.
Oh, Patchy and Juniper look like they're best friends. Let's see what else we can...
There they are. They're bezies. Okay, we're looking for some little rodent thing. Maybe it climbs trees? No, let's go back to the left, I guess. Come on, come on. I'm not in the best position. You meant to be on the floor for this and stuff, so I'm obviously not. Hello.
This primitive mammal is called an alphadon.
Cool. Can you find the other two?
There's two? There's three of them? I struggled to find one. Okay. I'm a detective. I can see you over there.
That's your second alphadon. Can you see the last one? There's a new dinosaur in the scene. Can you find it?
Well, there's that guy. Hello, Poppet.
You found all the mammals.
Now there's another dinosaur somewhere. Oh, there he is. Hello.
No, that's Gorgon.
Gorgon's on the prowl for fresh meat. This Pentaceratops isn't going down easily, and he gives as good as he gets.
Let's hope they don't come any closer.
Oh, hello, Poppet.
This is an Edmontosaurus, a giant herbivore, the size of a bus.
Oh,
bus! Wow. He's so excited.
He's big.
Poke you with my stick.
Ew, dino snot.
As the heat rises, Oak leads the herd on their annual migration to the cooler nesting grounds. It's a long journey. So they'll need all the energy they can get.
Well done! You found all the dinosaurs!
Thanks.
Great! Let's see what we've unlocked.
Go. You can kind of tell it's for kids, can't you? What did I...
You've unlocked some fact cards.
Fact cards? That's all I ever wanted.
Edmontosaurus is one of the largest duck-billed dinosaurs we've ever found. Nowadays, we're fairly confident that they walked on all four legs, but scientists once believed they hopped around like kangaroos.
No way! Can you imagine something that big bouncing around?
Can you imagine? Crazy. This one in the bottom is quite hard to click. No, go away!
The largest duck-billed
dinosaur. Go away! Okay, so...
Alphadon were small rodents, similar to rats or ferrets. Scientists don't know much about them, because so far, they've only uncovered their fossilized teeth. Cretaceous birds were quite different to those living today. This Alexornis had a body like a finch, but instead of a beak, it had a mouth like a lizard's, full of small, sharp teeth.
We're learning so much.
Pachyrhinosaurus was similar in size to a rhino or elephant. Scientists think they probably lived in large herds, with adult dinosaurs sticking close to their children to protect them.
I feel smarter already. Wait, there.
Pentaceratops was the size of a pickup truck and armed with a huge set of horns. Its skull was enormous, one of the largest ever recorded in any land animal.
I love this thing.
Let's see what's on the next page.
The fact that it actually rotates and stuff, just, it's awesome. Okay.
Prehistoric plants. Many
plants
were once absolutely massive, just like the dinosaurs that fed on them.
Let's find out more. Point the controller at the picture and then press the move button.
It's summer, and the heat is forcing all the big dinosaurs to trek to cooler regions. For the plants, though, this is a fantastic time to grow.
Wow, just look at this place. I bet there's loads to find here. Use your controller to feel around. When you see the magnifying glass appear, press the move button.
Screw you, society. Bah. Okay, and suck. Yeah.
Waggle the controller as fast as you can.
Most prehistoric birds had reptilian jaws lined with small teeth. Some even had claws at the end of their wings, which may have been used to help them climb.
Cool. Oh, look at him. Get it. That must be bloody terrifying for the bird. Bloody terrifying. Ooh.
Hey, that's Patchy. But where's Juniper? She must be close by. Those two look like they were best friends. If you see her, shout out her name.
Oh no. Do I actually have to shout? What's she called? Juniper! Little dinosaur thing! Hey! I totally made it.
Oh, Patchy. Well, that'll teach Juniper for trying to sneak up on him. She doesn't look very happy, does she? Should we take a closer look at them?
Patchy needs all the food he can get to grow big and strong.
Subtle advertising for the children there. Bloody hell, Patchy.
Let's look at the other one.
Juniper can't stomach the tougher plants, so she prefers softer vegetation, like ferns.
Blah! It's just like this big stick of doom.
Should we take a closer look at him?
Suppose.
Oak needs to eat a whopping 50 kilos of plants a day to keep up his strength. That's about the same as 250 cabbages.
That's a lot of cabbage.
Let's see if we can find some food for the family. First, try to find a horsetail. Look carefully at the plant in the picture, then see if you can find it in the forest.
There it is, I see it.
Now place it over its picture on the other page.
So cool. So unbelievably cool.
Horsetails were much bigger in the Cretaceous period than they are today. Some species grew to over 100 feet tall.
Excellent! Now let's find a cycad plant.
Can Why is that excellent? The forest? Dun 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 dun. It's just this big stick of death that moves through the forest, eliminating everything. Going over here. Yeah. Come on. Alright.
Can you see the burrow? I wonder who.
Oh, there's something in there.
Shout as loudly as you can.
Get out of the burrow!
Hold on.
There we go.
Mammals called mammals evolved alongside dinosaurs. Mammals were very different, as they used milk to feed their babies and were warm-blooded. They grew to outlive the dinosaurs and eventually came to dominate life on Earth.
Cool. We can rotate the scene. I'm sorry. Forgive me. It's like I have to do this, basically. There you go. Calm down. Ah. There we go. This is completely messing with how I'd organise this in my mind. Bam.
Looks like that was the wrong plant. Shout as loudly as you can.
I'm not a 12-year-old child! I apologize how loud that must be for you guys, but needs must.
About the same time as dinosaurs appeared. The earliest mammals were tiny, shrew-like creatures, similar to the Alphadon.
Looks like that was the wrong plant.
There we go.
Cycads have been on the planet for an amazing 280 million years. They grow dozens of feet high, and some are as much as 1,000 years old.
Let's look for a fern. If you find one, we'll have the whole set.
It's there. It's there. I see it. Hooray!
Ferns survive by growing where other plants can't. On mountain ledges, dry desert rock faces, even high up on trees.
Hopefully you heard that. I tried to block the mic during the siren.
You identified all the plants.
Which is nigh on impossible in Manchester. What did they just... I didn't... Ooh. Ooh. Okay.
Prehistoric plants.
Did I win? What am I doing? Can I turn?
Life in the herd. Life in the prehistoric plants. Digging up the past.
Looks like you've completed everything on this page. Why don't you...
75 million years ago.
We've completed this page. Shall we play it again?
No.
Prehistoric plants.
So I guess that's what we have to do. But I just did that, didn't I? Okay, whatever. We're going to end it here. Wait. Thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Please do like... Please do like, comment, subscribe. And I'll see you lovely people in the next episode. Cheers. Much love, as always. Bye-bye.